Bioclues Talks. Myself, Saumyadip Sarkar, from Bioclues Organization and also from We The Microbiologist. Today we are having an important person from Midnapore University, and he's going to talk more about his research, specifically in machine learning. So we have the man himself. Hello.
Hello
sir, how are you?
Fine.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
And
it's a pleasure too.
Please tell me about your research.
Hi, I'm Partha Sarathi Das. I'm presently affiliated with the Vidyasagar University Bioinformatics Center, Midnapore, West Bengal. In our department, mainly I work with machine learning and systems biology approaches, and we try to code lots of things with R programming because we feel more than a program, it's more of an environment through which we can do lots in bioinformatics these days. Okay. And there are also other divisions or other groups in our department who are working on different ways of studying the proteins as such and functions.
Okay, so how you started off, from your PhD research, then your...
My liking towards bioinformatics goes way back when I was a student in master's degree. I did my master's in microbiology from Bangalore. And that time, I just got introduced to this newly emerging subject, and I felt in India that there should be lots of scopes for this subject because it's emerging, and globally there was a new demand for this subject. And I got, I felt it's very challenging also. Because a biologist here needs to learn the computers or mathematics, which we fear the most, I guess, as a biologist. So that challenge caught me in this subject.
So, if you go as a difference, if you take the studies as a different, we see the studies in in European colleges, and right now you're doing your research in Indian colleges. So, how do you see the difference in your studies, and right now, what is the development in Indian research?
Studies in bioinformatics in India, the college or university level, still in elementary education. Most of it is from the syllabus and directly from the books, and the latest things, the latest findings are not being translated towards studies in the classrooms. Because the subject is extremely evolving subject, so the book that was written 10 years back is completely obsolete by now. The websites and the software, everything changes, and often that is not translated.
So, what about the students? Are they interested in bioinformatics?
I feel previously students were a bit shy or a bit cautious towards taking up this new subject because, as I said earlier, it involves the challenge of embracing maths or computers for a biologist. But now I have seen the new era of students are coming up who are getting more aware about the recent developments in bioinformatics, and they feel there is really a nice scope in it. And later, what I have seen, when they get into the PhD, although they are doing something purely in microbiology or molecular biology, at the end for the analysis of data, they have to embrace bioinformatics.
Yeah,
so from there, the idea is coming up, bioinformatics is an essential part of studies in biology right now, and the point of view is changing. Even the teachers are incorporating more of bioinformatics and biostatistics in their syllabi right now, to come up with the colleagues that I have seen.
Okay. Now I'm going to ask something different. If you need to say something to the Indian research scholars, specifically who are doing research in bioinformatics, what are you going to say to the people?
I'll just say that you have already accepted challenges to find something new in the field of science, and why you are segregating between what kind of new thing you are going to do? Why don't you go for the latest thing? Bioinformatics is the latest hype in India. If IT was India's tomorrow, bioinformatics is going to be the Bharat's tomorrow. So BT or bioinformatics tomorrow, whatever you call it. So embrace it. There's a huge scope in it globally and Indian way also. And industries are also needing lots of bioinformatics in the next 10 years. So just embrace it, and it's not very tough, I should say.
So at the end, as we conclude, I need to ask you just last thing, if you have some comments, because I need to introduce you about Bioclues Organization, which is an evolving bioinformatics organization in India. So, what do you think about it?
Bioclues has been a foremost body in creating awareness about bioinformatics from the students to the teachers level since the last 10 years, what I have seen from the websites and other sources. And I think Bioclues has done a nice job in integrating the people from different walks or different streams of life into bioinformatics, because bioinformatics is actually an integrative subject, not an isolated field of study. And I think Bioclues should also try to bring more of industry and academia together so that there is more of collaboration and job prospects also. So I think Bioclues can do that very well, apart from the networking they are doing right now. And I am really flabbergasted about the activities of Bioclues. I wish them all the best. I am sure in the next 5 years, you are going to see Bioclues as a, in a larger format and more global way.
Thank you, Partha. Thank you for joining us. And keep watching Bioclues Organization and subscribe to this video. Thank you.